We love math!
Education District 3 is seeking new ways to inspire students' interest and progress in mathematics with the staging of the 2024 edition of its mathematics symposium under the theme Positive Perception for Progression in Mathematics Through Playing with Maths. Organizers think it's important to build excitement around the mathematics subject to ensure minimal stresses related with students' ability to advance and eventually become successful at passing mathematics examinations. Building on last year's release of a new district policy on mathematics, Education Officer for District 3, Francilet Lawrenson, says the cries for attention from students in the subject of mathematics are being heard, and symposiums of this nature give a sensible reply to their needs.
So, we need to serve the balanced mathematical meal in an ambience which will encourage the children. Every time we serve them a math meal, they will be ready to eat the food because it looks different, it appeals to their senses and their needs. And the ambience, they can sit at their desk all day. They will not learn, they get frustrated, hot, restless, all of that.
District 3's numeracy coordinator, Rochelle Jabati, says in order for students to grow in maths, there must be a passion instilled by the strategies employed by teachers, both within and outside the classroom.
As we can see, the children that we have today are no longer the students who will sit in front of the class and listen to you, lecture them. They need to play. They need to talk. They need to share their experiences.
The Ministry of Education has hired a consultant on mathematics in the person of former Babano Secondary School Principal Terence Fellinor to spearhead the country's response to a recorded low performance in mathematics. The symposium included presentations on playing with maths and frank expressions from students of schools within District 3 on how they feel about being taught mathematics.
Before, when I started doing math, I didn't really understand math. Like, I was doing bad. But after, ever since I came here and she started teaching me, I kind of got the understanding of, like, math and, like, how to do it.
Sometimes teachers kind of rush through the different concepts, which is very confusing for most students. And when it comes to explaining on one-on-one, they can be, like, either upset or get, like, aggravated about it, which I don't really find helps with the whole subject, and it gives me a dislike into it.
Deputy Chief Education Officer Cyrus Sipal says dealing with mathematics issues within the education sector requires a united front of policymakers working alongside the very people who experience those challenges on a day-to-day basis, the teachers and students.
The talk is over. It is now action time. But I will not stay in education and just simply spin in top in mud. We are talking about the same thing over and over, and there is not a difference. We have to be dynamic. We have to be creative. We have to, listen, as Martin Luther King said, you have to amend the status quo. Go close to it. Go to the edge of the status quo and be willing to make a difference.
Mr. Sipal commended District 3 for being pioneers of this change within the education sector, suggesting that some schools within the district be used as pilot schools in an upcoming project to be announced soon to directly confront the challenges of numeracy within the education sector. From the Communications Unit of the Department of Education, Innovation and Vocational Training, I am Chris Satney, reporting.